Hey guys, so you got your regular mixers and blenders, and then you got these. And I'm going to make slime in them. And they have not just those, but an entire family of appliances. The moment I saw these, I was like, I had to buy them. They're so cute and tiny. I mean, just look at them. So all of these appliances take batteries, and they take AA batteries. You have to unscrew the screw and then insert the batteries, which is a little inconvenient in my opinion, but yay for extra security. So before I start making slime in the mixer, I wanted to make my activator solution, so I'm going to be doing that with the kettle that was in the set. I really thought that it would heat up.
I mean, I don't understand.
It's supposed
to heat up.
We shall proceed with our regularly scheduled program. Let's pretend that didn't happen and move on with our lives. I mean, I really thought that it would heat up. It took two batteries. As soon as the slime thickens up, the mixer hook thing, it slows down significantly. I guess that's expected because it's obviously not as powerful as a regular size mixer. Also, I think I added way too much glue. I kind of had to position the hook in a certain angle to get it to work, as well as manually holding the bowl. It came out clumpy and liquidy, but I know that if I added more activator, it would be more overactivated than it already is. I just had to knead it and play with it a bit. This time, I'm not going to add as much glue. I'm going to add some baby oil to give us some gloss and one tiny pump of face wash, just one. I really didn't need to add this much coloring for the amount of glue that I had, but lesson learned. So far, I really like this machine. She or he or neutral, maybe small, but it works. It does the job. Can you just imagine bringing this to your friend's house or just bring this somewhere and start making slime? Or be like, hey, do you want to make one cookie? Let's make one cookie. Let's do that. Now we have the blender in the set. Well, they call it a juicer, but it looks like a blender. I don't know if the lid is supposed to be open, but that thing is attached to the container like how your arm is attached to your body. I tried so hard to open it. I might have been a little too aggressive, and I broke the top trying to open the lid. So there were already styrofoam beads in it, I'm guessing to showcase that's where you mix your fruits and mix your whatever as a visual example. So for the first slime I'm going to make in this, I added some glue, some shaving foam, coloring, and rainbow foam beads. Something I noticed with the mixer and the blender, every time you turn it on, it lights up. So if you happen to use these at night or in the dark, these machines got your back. The thing is, I don't know how much that drains your battery, so... Here is the slime all finished. I think I added maybe too many beads. I'm not sure if that's the reason, but sometimes the beads would fall out and some of them lost its color, so it don't look as how I want it to be, unfortunately, but it still made slime. For the second slime, I really wanted to make some butter slime. I wanted to see if this blender would blend up the clay and mix it into the slime. Now I know the blade is not sharp, no one's trying to get sued here. It's not like regular blenders. I still wanted to try it out. So the slime formed, but it seems like the clay just stayed on the outside and didn't really get mixed into it. Also, it was doing that thing where it slows down towards the end when it starts to get thicker. After taking it out, I had to manually knead the clay in myself, and that's when it became this. This is probably my favorite slime that I made in this video. Before I end this video, I had to test out the coffee machine that was included, but instead of coffee, I'm gonna test it out with water. Pretty neat, if I do say so myself. And that concludes this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.